Hello everyone, welcome to the Nursing Virus channel. This is me, Loganathan. This video regarding the job notification in India. The job notification from CRPF. For checking this announcement, you can go to the site, that is www.crpf.gov.in. This is the direct website. From the official website, you can check the notification. After opening that main site, go down and you can see the notification from the recruitment area. You click view all. After opening the recruitment page, you can see the post, that is a notification for the recruitment of paramedical staffs with that advertisement number, and click the view details, and you can see that and PDF file for the notification. So this is the notification PDF file, that is the advertisement notice for the paramedical staff nurse examination 2020. So these posts are temporary but likely to become permanent. Under this area, you can see the sub-inspector, staff nurse under the serial number 2. The total number of vacancies 175. For that CR of staff nurse vacancy and sub-inspector, the group B, code number 02. The total number of posts 175. Under that various caste wise, that UR 81, OBC 40, SC 26, ST 11. EWS 17, totally 175 nursing post they were called. The salary level 6, 35,400 rupees to 112,400 rupees in Indian currency. The application opening date July 20, 2020, and closing date will be August 31st, 2020. Qualification for this nursing vacancy, the basic qualification is GNM or BSc nursing, or even if you are completed MSc nursing or any other additional qualification along with this basic qualification, you are eligible. And compulsory, the person need to be registered in the nursing council. The age limit will be below 30 years, and the age relaxation we have with the basic qualification detail, that is a GNM or BSc nursing, or even if you are overqualified, that is a MSc nursing, if you are completed also, you can apply. Along with that, this qualification, you need to have the physical standards and physical efficiency test. For that, you are EWS and SC and OBC candidates. For the male and female, we have the separate category, that is for the height qualification, 170 centimeter for a male, and for a female 157 centimeter, and for the chest 80 centimeter, and minimum expansion 5 centimeter you can have. And for the female candidate, it's not applicable. Then we have the relaxation in height to scheduled tribes and hill people. For the physical efficiency test, we have a 3 things need to get eligible, that is a race, long jump and high jump. For the race, in case of male, 1 miles race in 7 minutes and 30 seconds. And in case of females, that is only 800 meters race in 6 minutes. And for the long jump, 10 feet, there'll be 3 chances will be given. And for the females, 6 feet only. And for the high jump, 3 feet for the in case of male. And for the female, 2.5 feet. So this long jump and high jump, the 3 chances will be given, but for the race, there'll be only 1 chance will be given. The examination fee detail, in case of unreserved and EWS or OBC candidates, especially male candidate, only 200 rupees as application fee. In case of female, there is no fee. And compulsory, that 200 rupees can be taken in the Indian postal orders and bank draft only. In any other mode, if you are taking, your application can be rejected. the bank draft can be taken in the favor of DIGP, Group Center, CRPF, Popal, payable at SBI, Bangladesh. So this is the address for taking that 200 rupees demand draft. The examination center in the various parts of India, that is New Delhi, Hyderabad, Guwahati, Jammu, Prayagraj, Ajmer, Nagpur, Muzaffarpur, and Pallipuram. These are the 9 centers you can apply. These are the 9 examination centers. Based on your reachable area, you can keep the examination center in the application. And how you can apply for this post mail? There is no online application filling. Compulsory, you need to take that printout and handwritten copy of the application you need to take. Along with that, photocopies of all relevant document which is self-addressed, and 2 latest passport size photograph you need to take. This is the main 3 thing you need to take in the cover, that is the application form and photocopies of all relevant document which is self-addressed, and 2 latest passport size photograph. These are the 3 documents you are going to attach. And over the cover, you need to write as Central Reserve Police Force Paramedical Staff Nurse Examination 2020. If you are not writing this information over the cover, your application can be rejected. The postal address will be DIGP Group Center, CRPF, Popal, Village, Bangladesh, Taluk, Hazur, District, Popal, and the pin code, Madhya Pradesh 462045. This is the postal address you need to send. And the application selection process will be under the 4 stages. The first stage, you need to get qualified for the physical standard test and physical efficiency. If you are passing this first stage, then only you are eligible to go for the written examination. And when you are getting passed on this stage 1, you can be given for the exam admission card for going for the written examination. The written examination can be considered 100 question and total time period is 2 hours. You have a two parts of questions, that is a part A and part B. Under the part A, you have that general intelligence and reasoning for the 10 questions, and each question carry 1 mark. And for the general awareness, the current affairs, 10 questions will be, and the numerical aptitude, 15 question. And for the English and Hindi comprehension, based on your optional, you can go. It is not compulsory either English or Hindi. Based on your optional, you can take, that is the 50 questions. Totally, you will have 50 questions for the part A. And for the part B, it's all about your professional traits, that is the nursing related questions. So totally 50 questions from that part B, that is nursing related questions. For the cutoff mark, that is for the unreserved and EWS and ex-serviceman, compulsory 50% from the total mark. And for the SC, ST and OBC candidate, 45% from the total mark. So all the questions will be in the form of MCQ or multiple choice question. And after completing that written examination, you'll be called for the stage 3 examination and selection process. That is a trade test and screening of the document. And under the stage 3, you will have that 20 marks total. How it can be divided mean? The practical test in the concentrate, including handling of the tools and equipments, that is considered 10 marks. And for the knowledge about the tools or the equipments, 5 marks. And for the working experience alone, 5 marks will be given. That is, if you have the 5 years experience, 5 marks, 4 years mean 4, and 3 years, 3 marks, and 2 years, 2 marks. And if you are having at least 1 year of experience, you'll be given 1 mark. And the cutoff mark for that trade test and the screening of the documents is, for the UR, EWS and ex-serviceman, 10 marks out of 20. And for that OBC and SC and ST candidates, 9 marks out of 20. And if you are getting this cutoff mark, you'll go for that medical examination, and there will be the medical declaration, like either you are fit or unfit, can be made by the selection committee. If you have any doubts on that filling of application, you can ask me in the comments box. Thank you for joining with me. And
do subscribe on Nursing Virus channel if you not yet done. And don't forget to click the bell icon and like button so you don't miss any videos.